Welcome to the Shed. This is Iced Out Images coming at you with another music reaction. We're going to attempt for my first time using this setup. I may end up having to put a sound bar or something just to get the sound to just hit the way I want it to. And I'll be working at getting a better camera than camera mic versus what I'm using right now, which is my iPhone XS Max. So anyone that wants to do this, you can start off with cell phones. If you can figure out how to use the iMovie app that comes with your phone, you can get your editing skills down doing it that way. Otherwise, you're like me, you're behind the eight ball and you got to figure it out yourself. But I'll get there. So this one's Machine Gun Kelly, Smoke and Drive. It's from a month ago, so behind the eight ball. 16 million views. I was listening to one of my playlists at work the other day, and one of his songs came on, and it just made me remember that he just put out a bunch of shit, and I think I've heard little snippets here and there as, like, you know, I got a video playing, and all of a sudden it cuts over to something, and you hear it from the other room, and you're like, oh, hey, I haven't heard that one yet. So, I know it's got a decent beat, but that's about it, and, he looks pretty fucking high right now already. His eyes are glossy as shit. He's got a nice mic with a... looks to be a... coupe? Yeah. You know, coupe. Two-door car. You know, no back door window. It's got the little slit windows. But whatever. We're going to get into this. I don't got any more of the other information other than it's 2 minutes and 30 seconds long. Machine Gun Kelly, let's get this shit. Forgot to roll up before doing this. Anybody else experience that? You're working your shitty little 9-to-5, making your minimum wage or whatever. And I'm not going to say, like, spent it on a hell of drugs, but, you know, back in the day, you know, you're kicking it with your boys. You're using it on alcohol, weed, whatever drug you may happen to be on at the time. So back in the day, ecstasy, acid, things like that. We used to get down with a bunch of that shit. So, you know, you get your paycheck, your measly little couple hundo, and next thing you know is you're just out blowing it on pills and shit, going out, trying to have the best time you can before you gotta go back to work and do that shit again. But from the looks of it, it looks like he's in a Aston Martin, probably like a Vanquish or DB7 Vanquish. I think they're the same fucking model, except one of them's like, I think the next step up. Could be wrong, plus I think that's an older model that I'm talking about, not what he's in. Obviously, it's just probably brand new in 2020. In quarantine, but the weed man pulls up here. Just right there, he said he spent 10k cash. Like, damn, man, I wish I had 10k cash to fucking blow on some dope. Like, the weed man's still pulling up, trust me. You know, got a little bit on the tray. Got a little bit left in this jar. Got like 2 or 3 more eighth baggies over here. But nowhere near 10 grand worth of shit, that's for damn sure. I also don't got money like this guy. Plus, he puts out banger after banger. Like, I mean, people were like, oh, his one CD binge or whatever was trash. I liked it. I didn't feel that it was his best stuff, but I didn't think it was garbage like some other people were saying. I didn't feel that way personally as a fan. But I'm loving this stuff. Oh damn. He started going in right there. That threw me for a loop for a second, right as I went to pause it. He's gonna put his hood on like Trayvon. He don't give a fuck about the cops. You know? Most of you know about Trayvon Martin and the Zimmerman thing. So, and if you don't know, you've heard other artists talk about putting 100 bands. Roddy Ricch, I'm gonna put 100 bands or 1,000 bands on his fucking head. Whatever, he just... People keep talking about putting money on the man's head because of what went down. So, fuck the cops. That's what he's saying. Giving out, you know, it sounds like he's paying some homage to Trayvon Martin's memory, you know. I got a house in the hills, but I'll still smack y'all. So he lives upper class, but it still slap you like he in the hood, like he on the corner. I forget what he said the corner was. 120 and if is where the party store or whatever was in his one song. They call it the if. I'm pretty sure some of you also have heard that song before. I'm loving this. I like the beat. I like the way he's riding it. And then when he kicked into that fast flow, it was like... Phew. It's like the new smoke anthem right now for the summer at the moment. It makes me want to put this in my car and just... Drum machine and the piano. Wonder how much of this shit he did himself, you know? Obviously you can tell those aren't his hands in some of the video little clips, but come on. Oh yeah, that shit was dope. So apparently that one's played before. Okay, looks like through one of my playlists, it played a few of these songs. You can clearly see that these two look like they've been played, and these ones haven't yet. See what that's all about. I know I haven't listened to this one yet. Just heads up, I do have other people that use my my YouTube account at the moment. My 4-year-old son. But yeah, we're definitely going to get into more of MGK stuff. Yeah, looks like these two have been played at some point in time, and they're the newest ones. Those were the ones I was going to do next, so with that being said, I'll catch you guys in the next one. MGK, you're doing it huge. I love your music. One of my favorite of all time is The Return, you know, spitting some real shit, talking about your life and all that shit. I love that song, but I love this stuff. What you're putting out now is just quality. And then, as I said, I'll see what these two are about. Sounds good. All right. Love you guys. Like, sub, comment, hit the bell for future videos. And I'm still trying to work out the area. So bear with me. Appreciate you guys. Love you guys. Have a fantastic day and catch you in the next one.